Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to our Wednesday night Bible study in Isaiah.
弟兄姊妹们好，晚上好，欢迎来到我们周三晚以赛亚查经。
We are looking at the section where there are servant songs about the Lord Jesus.
我们看这一部分以赛亚书是关于讲到主的仆人，我们主耶稣的歌。
If you'll remember in chapter 42, we saw the first servant song.
大家记得在以赛亚42章里我们看到第一首仆人的歌。
Now in Isaiah chapter 49 tonight we will see the second servant song.
今天晚上在以赛亚书49章我们看到了关于主仆人之歌的第二首。
This is really quite a beautiful thing Isaiah has done.
这是以赛亚所记录的非常美好的一部分。
So beautiful.Was the Lord describing his son that Isaiah cast these songs in a rhythmic verse?
当神描述他的爱子的时候，以赛亚把这个用着很有节奏的章节诗词一样记录下来。
Because in order to express the beauty of the Lord, he didn't use prose, he used poetry.
为了要表达主的美丽，他没有用散文的题材，而是用诗歌的题材。
And so the Hebrew scholars, as they see this poetry, some have called them servant poems, but others have said these are servant songs.
所以希伯来文的学者当看到这些诗的时候，有的人说这是关于仆人的诗，也有人说这是关于仆人之歌。
So let's see how the Lord sings this second song tonight.
让我们看一下主他如何来唱这首第二首仆人之歌今天晚上。
First, a word of prayer.
上面有一些祷告。
Lord, as we come to you tonight, we want to sing your praises.
主今天晚上我们来到你的面前，我们愿意唱你的诗歌。
We're so thankful for verses throughout the Word of God.That give us the words to express how great you are.
按你的赞美，主啊，在整本圣经当中，有给了我们很多的话来赞美你何等的伟大。
Even when you came down to this earth and lived in the flesh for 3 years, there was something so beautiful about your service.
主啊，哪怕你道成了肉身，来到地上33年，在你的服事的当中。有非常多的美丽。
So help us, Lord, to be able by your Spirit to walk with Jesus through his baptism, through his ministry, through the cross, and through to the throne.
主啊，借着你的圣灵帮助我们能够与耶稣同行，借着他的受尽，借着他的服事，借着他的上十字架，主啊，能够见到他的美丽。
We do thank you for your precious word.
我们谢谢你宝贝的话语。
We pray in Jesus' precious name.
我们祷告奉靠耶稣宝贝的名。Amen.
Amen. We'll begin just with a brief overview here because there's always some new people perhaps joining us.
我们有可能有些新的弟兄姊妹朋友来参加我们的查经，所以我们开始的时候有简单的回复。
We've been watching Isaiah as he's grown in his life with the Lord.
我们看到以赛亚在神的生命当中，主的生命当中成长。
We saw Isaiah in the first 12 chapters of his book as he became a prophet when he was consumed by a vision of Jehovah sitting upon a throne.
我们看在前面12章的时候，以赛亚被耶和华坐在宝座上的意象所占据，他在主的里一直成长。
In that time, he saw that a virgin would conceive and bear a son whose name is Emmanuel.
他作为先知一直成长，那时候他看见了童女要生子，他的名字叫以马内利。
And then he further saw that a child would be born and the government would rest upon his shoulders.
他后来也看到有一子为我们生，政权必担在他肩上。
So as a prophet, he was seeing these things about our wonderful Lord.
所以作为一个先知，他看到这些关于我们主的啊奇妙的这些事物。
And then we came to the second section from chapters 13 to 23, where we see Isaiah now as a watchman upon the walls with prophetic insight about all the nations around Judah and what God was going to do with these nations.
我们看到以赛亚13章到23章这第二部分的时候，以赛亚是作为一个对列国和历史具有先知洞察力的，从属天的视角的一个守望者。
And as he saw God's judgments upon the nations and God's mercy toward Israel, he became an intercessor praying for revival among the Lord's chosen people.
当看到主对列国的审判和对以色列的拣选拯救，他就为神的选民成为一个为主复兴神的选民的代祷者。
And this resulted in those later chapters in the greatest miracle in the life of Judah when Hezekiah, through prayer with Isaiah, withstood Sennacherib and the Assyrian invasion.
所以这里结束就在以赛亚和西西家在借着祷告然后阻止了亚述的大军。
But that's the first 39 chapters and the first half of Isaiah.
这就是以赛亚书前半部分里的39章所记述的。
All these ministries were important in Isaiah's life.
所有这些服事在以赛亚的生命当中都是非常重要的。
But they all led to this highest ministry of Isaiah as he bore the testimony of Jesus in chapters 40 through 66.
然而以赛亚当中他最高的服事就是从40章到66章里面他承受耶稣基督的见证这位先知。
Isaiah, with eyes open to heaven, saw that Jesus, the suffering servant, would die to save us from our iniquities.
以赛亚借着天向他打开，他看到神受苦的仆人为着救赎我们而死。
So we're at the deepest stage in Isaiah's life.
所以我们在以赛亚生命当中最深的一层。
This is also the deepest stage of our lives when we bear the testimony of Jesus to the world.
这是我们生命能够达到最深的一层，就是我们对着世界做耶稣基督的见证。
Now in these chapters we see that the servant of the Lord has several different meanings throughout these chapters.
在这些章节当中，我们看到主的仆人是有着不同层次的意思的。
Number one, Isaiah himself is called a servant of the Lord because of his faithful service.
第一点呢，以赛亚他本人因着他忠心服侍神的缘故，他也被称为神的仆人。
But number two, we see that Israel as a nation was called and destined to be the corporate servant of the Lord.
然后我们看到以色列因着蒙召，以色列命定成为主团体的仆人。
Number three, we've seen that Cyrus was called the servant of the Lord as he delivered the captive children from Babylon and brought them back to Jerusalem.
第三点我们看到古列也成为拯救以色列百姓从巴比伦的拯救者，他乃是主所拣选的特定的仆人。
But then we have the servant of the Lord who is unique.
然后呢，我们就有一个关于特别的主的那一个仆人。
Even Jesus Christ is revealed as the servant of the Lord.
就是耶稣基督被启示成为作为主的仆人。
Only he could bring redemption and deliverance to the people of God through his suffering.
只有他能够借着他自己的受苦，能够将神的子民 救赎和拯救。
He is the chosen, the beloved servant.
他是那一个神所爱的，那一个神所拣选的仆人。
Now we see these servant songs of Isaiah.
我们在这里看到了以赛亚书里面关于仆人之歌的。
And each of these songs reveals something more about the Lord Jesus.
这每一首歌都更加的启示了关于我们主耶稣基督的。
We see that one was in chapter 42, and then tonight we see the one in chapter 49.
我们看到第一首在42章，然后今天晚上我们看见第二首在49章。
Then there'll be one more in chapter 50, and then finally the most important one in chapters 52 and 53.
然后还有一首，第三首是在50章，然后最后的一首，最重要的一首在52章到53章。
Now each, this, in the first servant song, we saw that the servant was Jehovah's heart's desire.
在第一首仆人之歌当中，我们看到这个仆人是耶和华心所喜悦的。
You remember how the Lord said, Behold my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen one, in whom my soul delights.
大家记得主说，这是我的仆人，我所拣选的。我所喜悦的。
And he said many things about him. He would bring forth justice. He would not break a bruised reed.
也讲到了关于很多主的事情，讲到了他必将公理传给外邦，讲到他也不折断压伤的芦苇。
He would open blind eyes. He would bring out prisoners from the dungeon.
他会使瞎子的看见，他也会使被囚的得自由。
And of course, this Isaiah chapter 42, verse 1, was quoted when Jesus came out of the waters of baptism, and God said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased.
然后在这首诗歌里的第一节，42章第一节，当主耶稣受尽之后，在马太福音中有引用说，从天上有声音说，这是我的爱子，我所喜悦的。
Now, as we look tonight at the second servant song, we see the servant's testimony of his service while here on earth.
那我们看到今天第二首关于仆人的歌，他讲到这个仆人讲到他在地上所做的所有的见证。
It has three stanzas, we would say.
这首歌有三节。
First, the servant testifies of his calling that Jehovah has given to him.
首先，仆人见证了他所蒙的呼召，就是耶和华所给他的呼召。
But then in the second stanza, the servant shares his disappointments and his human frailty.As he puts all his trust and hope in Jehovah.
在第二部分，仆人也分享了他的失望和在他人性软弱当中他的失望，但是同时他也将他的信任和盼望都放在耶和华的身上。
And then in the third stanza or verse of the song, the servant hears God's answer to the servant regarding the far-reaching effect of his faithfulness.
然后第三部分这些歌词就讲到仆人听见了神回应他，告诉他因为他的忠心所产生深远的影响。
So let's begin looking at this wonderful song.
让我们来开始看这首美好的诗歌。
It begins in verse 1. Listen to me, O islands.And pay attention, you peoples from afar.
他从第一节开始说，众海岛啊，当听我言，远方的众民啊，留心耳听。
So you see, this is the servant himself speaking to the Gentiles, the people in the islands and the peoples from afar.
这里是仆人在对那些外邦人的说话，对那些海岛啊和远方的民讲话。
Now, what does he testify?
他见证什么呢?
He says, the Lord called me from the womb, from the body of my mother, he named me.
他说，自我出胎，耶和华就招选我，出自母腹，他就提我的名。
Now here the servant is saying that I have begun to understand my calling that came from the womb before I was even born. I was named.
这里仆人在这里讲说，我就明白了耶和华对我的呼召，哪怕在我出母腹之前，我就被赐予名字。
And of course, we remember how this was fulfilled when the angel Gabriel first said to Mary, his name shall be called Yeshua, or Jesus, for he shall save my people.
我们记得这个预言如何应验，就是加百列对玛利亚说他必生一童子，给他起名叫耶稣，他要拯救他的百姓从罪恶当中。
And then we have in verse 3 of Isaiah 49, he said to me, you are my servant Israel, in whom I will show my glory.
然后我们在第三节记得他对我说，你是我的仆人以色列，我必因你得荣耀。
Now just as when we are saved, we are baptized into the body of Christ as we go into the water.
当我们得救的时候，我们受浸，我们浸到水里，我们受浸归于基督的身体。
In the same way, Jesus, as he was baptized, was identifying with the people of Judah and Israel. You are my servant Israel.
所以同样的，当主耶稣受浸的时候，他就把自己和神的子民来认同。所以在这里他就说，我是你的仆人以色列。
And of course, how true it was that in Jesus, God's glory was seen.
的确，这是何等的真实，在耶稣的里面，神的荣耀被彰显出来。
But then we come to verse 2, where he continues to testify of what God has done.
所以第二节，他进一步见证神所做的。
He has made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he has concealed me.
讲到他使我的口如快刀，又将我藏在他手阴之下。
In other words, my mouth is a sharp sword. God gave him a powerful and prophetic word for him to preach as he went through Galilee.
这里讲他口如快刀，就是神给他一个强有力的信息，当主在加利利服事的时候传道。
But this word was given to him in the secret place, under Jehovah's hand, as they fellowshipped together.
而这话就是当主耶稣与父神耶和华有交通的时候，是在耶和华手中秘密处所赐给了主耶稣。
And then he says, and he has also made me a select arrow, and he has hidden me in his quiver.
所以他又讲到，又使我成磨亮的剑，将我藏在他箭袋之中。
Now here you see again this twofold testimony.
在这里我们再次看见了两重的见证。
God has made him in his person and in his message.A sharp arrow.
神已经将主耶稣在他的个人和在他的话语当中使他成为一个锋利的剑。
When he ministered, it was like a sharp sword that severed and exposed the truth as he preached the gospel.
当主来服事的时候，讲传道的时候，那个话可以像利剑，能够刺入，能够剖开，当他传福音的时候。
And yet, he has hidden me in his quiver.
然而他却把我藏在他箭袋之中。
So in other words, he rested in his father's quiver until the father sent him forth as a sword, as an arrow.
换句话说，他就安息在父神的箭袋当中，直到父神把他像箭射出来一样。
So here he is with a powerful ministry, yet hiding in the secret place, with a sharp sword, and yet waiting and depending upon Jehovah and his quiver.
在这里我们就看到他的强有力的服饰，然而是藏在神的隐秘处。他这如同锋利的，他的服饰如同锋利的剑，然而却藏在耶和华的剑袋中。
And for all of us who would minister the word of God, whether in teaching a Sunday school class or teaching brothers and sisters, it's so important to have that secret life depending on the Lord as we are made by him, an arrow and a powerful mouth.
所以就像我们在服侍神话语的时候，无论你是教主日学或是讲道，我们就要像就要与神有一个秘密处，有一个关系，与神同行，与神的个人的关系。同时我们也要好像，我们就好像神所预备的利剑，当他把我们射出来的时候能够有效锋利。
Now we have the testimony continuing, and here again the servant is speaking about what the Lord has said.
然后这里进一步讲述神的见证，这里讲到说仆人所讲述的话。
The Lord said to me, "You are my servant Israel, in whom I will show my glory."
他对我说，你是我的仆人以色列，我必因你得荣耀。
But now suddenly we hear how human this servant is.
这里我们突然听见这个仆人他是何等的确是一位人。
In verse 4 he says, But I said, I have toiled in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity.
第四节，我却说我劳碌是徒然，我尽力是虚无虚空。
We don't realize how much the Lord suffered as he ministered here on earth.
我们常常不理解我们的主在地上服侍的时候他受了多少苦。
The scriptures tell us he learned obedience by the things that he suffered.
圣经告诉我们他借着所受的苦难而学了顺服。
Imagine him being the sower of seed, but he saw most of the seed was wasted on bad ground.
大家想象他在那里来撒种，但是很多的种子都浪费在了荒地上面。
Or imagine the servant being a teacher who would teach, but he saw the blindness and the deafness that the tradition and religion had brought to the people.
他也作为一个教师，但是他也看见那些传统和宗教让人是何等的瞎眼耳聋。
Or again, we see the servant, a holy servant, who did great things and healed many, but saw sins undoing so much of the good that he had achieved.
或者我们看到神的仆人他是这样的圣洁，他做了很多的救主的工作，然而是因着罪的缘故，让他很多的工作都打了折扣，都毁掉了他的工作。
So,We're led into the secret place of the servant of the Lord's human soul.
所以我们带到了一个隐秘的处，就是神仆人他的灵魂的奥秘隐秘处。
And the servant confesses that his soul is spent of strength and senses that what much of what he's done has been in vain.
这个仆人在这里就承认他的灵魂里面的力量都用尽了，他所做的很多好像都虚无，没有果效。
But even though he has feels like he has spent his strength in vain, we see the end of verse 4 where it says, "Yet surely the justice due to me is with Jehovah, and my reward is with my God."
虽然神的仆人觉得他的劳碌是徒然，但是我们在第四节四节的后半部看到主说，然而我当得的礼必在耶和华那里，我的赏赐必在我神那里。
Now here is such an important lesson that we who are redeemed can learn from our precious Lord.
这里我们一切被救赎的都可以从我们宝贝的主身上学到一些宝贵的功课。
You know, as human beings, our souls become weary and discouraged, and we think sometimes what we're doing is fruitless.
作为一个人，我们的灵魂有的时候觉得，当我们做的东西没有果效的时候，我们会很失望、沮丧。
Especially here, the servant says he feels he has spent his strength for nothing.
尤其是这普里的仆人说，我的劳碌是徒然。
You know, when you think of it, Jesus served for 3.5 years, bringing his disciples around, and yet when he came, what was going to Calvary, all he had was a small group of followers through after all of that ministry.
大家想想主耶稣在地上3.5年的服事，有一群的门徒跟随着他，然而当主耶稣快钉十字架的时候，这些人就只有这些人，他们都也要离去。
But we see the word yet.
但这里我们看到了这个词，然而。
He looked beyond his soul, beyond his feelings, beyond his human frailty and weakness, and he put his trust in Jehovah.
然而他在这里转眼不看他灵魂里面的感觉和软弱，然而他却要信靠耶和华。
Certainly, the justice due to me is with Jehovah.
所以耶和华那里他必有给我的公义和赏赐。
What does that mean?
这里的意思是什么呢？
God is the one who approves our work. We don't look at the outward things. We look to God to justify our service and ministry.
是最后来神来决定来看我们的工作。所以我们不用看我们服事的外面的环境和果效，因为最后有神在那里替我们判断，替我们赏赐。
And we see that Jesus says, and my reward is with my God. In other words, he knew that he would be rewarded for his faithful kingdom service.
耶稣在这里说，我的赏赐必在我神那里，因为耶稣在这里他讲到说，他知道在神国度的服事里，神必定会给他赏赐。
Now this simple passage says so much to us.
这个简单的经节讲述了很多的内容给我们。
We see the incarnation of the Word of God that became flesh and dwelt here upon this earth.
我们看到了神的道成肉身，在地上，活在这地上。
And as he dwelt upon this earth, his soul responds with emotions, with feelings, with thoughts, even as ours as well.
他在这地上生活的时候，他的灵魂，他也有情感，他也有感觉，跟我们是一样的。
We see that Jesus' calling was marked by intimacy with the Father and with an increasing sense of solitude in this evil world.
我们看见在耶稣的呼召当中，他也是充满着与父神的亲密，而且在这一个罪恶的世界当中，他会变得好像越来越孤独。
Perhaps we could say that the theme of this first stanza is, as I have up at the top, Jesus' lonely pathway.
我们可以这样总结，在这第一段的歌词当中呢，其实像这标题讲述耶稣孤单的道路。
His life of works and teachings was poured out without comfort and consolation or success in this world.
主耶稣他倾倒他一生的工作和教导，然而在这个世界上却没有得到安慰和成功。
This lonely way of the cross he trod by turning away from human feelings, these needed comfort and divine consolation.
他在这个远离人类情感而走在这条孤独的十字架的道路上的时候，他需要安慰和神的慰藉。
Now these simple words in this song should teach us at least a few things.
这些简单的诗歌词教导我们几件事情。
First of all, we need to understand that our encouragement in the end must come from the Lord Himself.
第一点我们需要明白的就是我们的鼓励最终是要从神他自己那里来。
If we're looking to the praises of men as we minister, we'll find ourselves weary and defeated. But our consolation and our trust is in our God.
与其说看到我们身边的人对我们的鼓励，我们其实常常会非常的沮丧失望，但是我们应该看到我们所信靠的是神。
We also see that we cannot let our soul dominate our spirit.
我们也可以，也应当看到，我们不应该让我们的灵魂来支配我们的灵。
Though the soul of the servant was cast down, yet in faith his heart arose in trust of his God.
虽然这个仆人他的魂是很低沉低落的，然而在信心当中，他的灵能够起来，能够信靠神。
So often God's children become so weary and so discouraged, but it's because they don't have faith. They haven't trusted God and be comforted in God and believe that God will justify those things that are done in His name.
很多时候有些神的仆人，神的儿女，他们是这样的沮丧，他们没有起来在信心当中，在灵里相信神是最终使他们称义的那一位，是最终来奖赏他们的那一位。
And as we will see again with the servant of the Lord, the test of the enemy is to cause him to feel that he is separated from God and all alone.
我们也将看到这个神的仆人他所面临的这种试探试验，就是他让他好像与神分离，好像只是他自己在那里受苦的感觉。
But you even remember when Jesus fed the 5,000 and it turned many disciples away who would not follow him, Jesus didn't become discouraged. He put his trust in God.
大家记得当主耶稣行喂饱5000人的神迹之后，有很多人转而不跟从他。但是耶稣却没有说很沮丧，反而他起来来赞美神。
Now we come to the second stanza, second verse in this servant song.
现在我们来到第二段关于这个神仆人之歌。
Now he testifies of what Jehovah said to him as he confessed his loneliness and discouragement.
在这里见证当他向神倾诉他的沮丧，他的孤独的时候，耶和华所对他所讲的话。
And so Jehovah says, and now says Jehovah, who formed me from the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, so that Israel might be gathered to him. For I am honored in the sight of Jehovah, and my God is my strength.
第五节，耶和华从我出胎，造就我做他的仆人，是要使雅各归向他，使以色列到他那里聚集。原来耶和华看我为尊贵，我的神也成为我的力量。
So you see, so now the Father answers the Son about these matters.
我们看到这时候父神以父神的身份回答他的儿子这些问题。
He continues to hold on to his calling, that he was called from the womb, that he would bring Jacob back to God, that Israel might be gathered back together.
主继续抓紧他的呼召就是从母胎神就对他的呼召，要使雅各归向他，使以色列到他那里聚集。
And as the servant, he knew that he was honored in the sight of Jehovah.
作为仆人，他也知道在耶和华眼中看他为尊贵。
Now, what is it Jehovah is going to say to this faithful, discouraged servant.
耶和华对这一个忠心，然后有些沮丧的仆人要说什么呢？
In verse 6, we discover. He says, Jehovah says, it is too small a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved ones of Israel.
在第六节，耶和华在这里说，现在他说，你做我的仆人，是雅各众支派复兴，是以色列宗得保全的归回，尚为小事。
I will also make you a light to the nations, so that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth.
我还要使你做外邦人的光，叫你施行我的救恩，直到地极。
The faithfulness of this servant is so great that here is what Jehovah says.
这位神的仆人是这样的忠心，所以耶和华这样讲。
Of course, you are my servant to restore Jacob.To bring Israel back together again.
的确，你作为我的仆人，你要使雅各支派复兴，使以色列宗保全的归回。
But I have a much larger plan in mind, even to make you a light to the Gentiles, so that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth.
但是我有更大的计划为着我的仆人，就是要使他作为外邦人的光，这样我的救恩可以直到地极。
Ah, how blessed the servant must have felt when he perceived that his calling and his faithfulness would reach further than he ever could imagine.
我们想到这个仆人，当他看见他的服事会带到更进一步，会带到地极的时候，救恩，他的心里应该是何等受了鼓励。
Now you know Jesus.The more he grew and he grew, and he understood more and more of what God's purpose was for him.
我们知道耶稣他成长又成长，然后他也进一步更加理解神对他的旨意如何。
As a child, he didn't know all these things.
作为一个孩童的时候，他可能不知道所有这一切。
When he was baptized, he saw.That he would have to lay down his life and die for Israel.
当他受浸的时候，他看到了他要放下他的生命，为了以色列而死。
And perhaps he had read this scroll and seen that the servant of the Lord would be made a light to the nations and a salvation to the ends of the earth.
他也可能读这个书卷的时候，他看到了神的仆人要成为外邦人的光，让神的救恩直到地极。
This was the joy that was set before him, that caused him to despise the shame and press on through the cross to his throne.
这个就是因着他前面所摆的喜乐，让他可以轻看苦难，然后通过十字架达到了宝座。
And then we have verse 7. Thus says Jehovah, the Redeemer of Israel and its Holy One, to the despised one, this is the servant,To the one abhorred by the nations, this is the servant. To the servant of rulers, kings will see and arise. Princes will bow down because of the Lord who is faithful, the Holy One of Israel who has chosen you.
所以在49节，救赎主以色列神在这里说的圣者，以色列的圣者耶和华，对那被人所藐视，想到这个仆人。为本国所憎恶，讲到这个仆人，官长所虐待的如此说，君王要看见就站起，首领也要下拜，都因信实的耶和华，就是拣选你以色列的圣者。
So Jehovah says as a servant, you'll be despised by many. You'll be abhorred by the Gentiles. You'll be a servant bowing down before kings in this world. But soon you will be Lord of all.And kings will bow down before you.
所以耶和华告诉他的仆人，虽然他的仆人必被以色列藐视，被外邦人所憎恶，虽然他也暂时在君王面前屈服，然而他却成为，他却是，他是一个王，君王都要向他下拜。
So that day would come when the chosen son.Would be exalted above every other name, and every knee would bow.
所以这位被拣选的神的儿子王，有一天万膝都要向他下跪，万口都要承认。
Then we have verses 8 and 9 as the testimony goes further.
然后在第八节、第九节，我们看到的见证就进一步的发展。
Thus says Jehovah, in a favorable time I have answered you, and in a day of salvation I have helped you, and I will keep you and give you for a covenant to the people, to restore to the land, to restore to the land, to make them inherit the desolate heritages, saying to those who are bound, go forth, to those who are in darkness, show yourselves.
第八节到第九节，耶和华如此说，在悦纳的时候我应允了你，在拯救的日子我记住了你，我要保护你，使你做众民的宗保，复兴遍地，使人承受荒凉之地为业，对那被捆绑的人说，出来吧，对那在黑暗里的黑暗的人说，显露吧。
So Jehovah says there'll be a time of grace when you will be the exalted servant.
所以耶和华说，将来会有一个恩典的时刻，你将成为我被高举尊贵的仆人。
You will be my salvation.
你会成为我的救恩。
You will be my covenant.
你也会成为我的宗保。
You will redeem the inheritance.
你也会为神的产业救赎。
You will release the bound. You will give light to the blind.
你会释放那被捆绑的人，你会成为瞎子人的光。
So we see at the end of stanza 2, we see in the latter days of his ministry, a far greater plan of salvation. That is rendered by the servant of the Lord.
我们看在仆人歌的第二段里，我们看到在耶稣传道的后期，他的救恩，这种更大的救恩的计划就彰显出来，包括了外邦人。
And he would become a covenant of redemption, a new covenant for the peoples.
他为着神的百姓成为一个拯救的救赎的新的约。
So there we see in this servant song, the servant as a human being going through trials and Jehovah giving him these great and precious promises to help him to press forward toward the goal.
所以我们在这第二部分看到耶和华的仆人作为一个人，他也会经历他的软弱、无力、沮丧，然而耶和华却把他的话赐给了这仆人，鼓励他让他能够被刚强，向着标杆来跑奔跑。
So we see that there will still be two more servant songs that will speak to us more about what the servant of the Lord will go through in his service to God.
然后我们看到还要加上两首仆人的诗歌，才能够完全讲述神的仆人所经历的。
Now, who is listening to this servant song?
谁在听这个仆人之歌呢?
Now, the servant has testified of what the Father has said.
仆人在见证父神所讲的话。
Now, there are the people hearing Isaiah speak.
百姓们听见了以赛亚讲话。
But many of them are blind and deaf because of idolatry.
他们很多人却是因着拜偶像，是瞎眼耳聋的。
But Zion is listening.
但是西安在这里听。
Zion here in this case, the faithful remnant, was like the servant discouraged in their trials, and they need to trust Jehovah, who will reassure of his love and of his redemption.
在这里西安神忠实的渔民就如同这个里讲述神的仆人一样，他们在这种试炼当中，他们也灰心，他们需要相信耶和华相信要耶和华重新肯定他的爱与救赎。
So now we read verses where the Lord speaks to this discouraged remnant, Zion.
现在我们就读到这些 经节，就是主来鼓励他这些被有些沮丧的锡安神的渔民们。
Now the story continues of what the servant will have done. They will not hunger or thirst, nor will the scorching heat of the sun strike them down. For he who has compassion on them will lead them and will guide them to springs of water.
这诗歌就继续讲，在第十节，不饥不渴，炎热和烈日必不伤害他们，因为连续他们的必引导他们，领他们到水泉旁边。
I will make all my mountains a road.And my highways will be raised up. Behold, they will come from afar. And lo, these will come from the north and from the west, and these will come from the land of Sinim.
我必使我的众山成为大道，我的大路也被修高。看哪，这些从远方来，这些从北方来，从西方来，这些从秦国来。
Shout for joy, O heavens! Rejoice, O earth!Break forth into joyful shouting, O mountains, for the Jehovah has comforted his people and will have compassion on his afflicted.
诸天啊，应当欢呼，大地啊，应当快乐，众山啊，应当发声歌唱，因为耶和华已经安慰他的百姓，也要连续他困苦之民。
And so the testimony of the servant's redemption spreads out through the world, even to Sinim, which I believe is China.Prophesied in Isaiah.
所以，这首诗歌里讲到神仆人救赎的见证啊，继续传遍了全世界。这里讲到从秦国来，我相信是讲到了中国。
But Zion is discouraged.
但是西安他却是感觉沮丧。
But Zion said in verse 14, "The Lord has forsaken me."And the Lord has forgotten me.
第十四节，西安说：“耶和华离弃了我，主忘记了我。”
You see, Zion is just like the servant, very human, feeling forsaken, feeling like the Lord has forgotten, because Zion are the remnant that are have to go through the terrible time of the captivity, and they'll have to suffer and feel forsaken.
我们知道这种这些渔民他们的感觉就好像神的仆人一样感觉耶和华离弃了他，耶和神忘记了他，因为大家记得这些锡安这些神的渔民，他们就是指以色列那一部分小部分的渔民，他们要经历被掳，在这些当中他们经历很多的软弱苦难。
So now Jehovah will comfort Zion, his precious remnant.
所以耶和华在这里他要安慰锡安神这些宝贝的渔民。
Verse 15, Can a woman forget her nursing child and have no compassion on the son of her womb? Even if these may forget, but I will not forget you. Behold, I've inscribed you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are continually before my face.
妇人岂能忘记她吃奶的婴孩，不连续她所生的儿子？既或有忘记，我却不忘记你。看哪，我将你铭刻在我掌上，你的强援常在我前。
The Lord says, I have not forgotten you. I've inscribed you in my hand. Your walls, Zion, are ever before my face, even though the walls have been torn down.
主在这里就讲说，我没有忘记你，没有忘记你的面，哪怕你的墙折断的墙也在我的面前。
Then we go on, verse 17. Your builders hurry, your destroyers and devastators will depart from you. Lift up your eyes and look around. All of them gather together. They come to you. As I live, declares Jehovah, you will surely put on all of them as jewels.And bind them on as a bride. For your waste and desolate places and your destroyed land, surely now you will be too cramped for the inhabitants, and those who swallowed you will be far away.
第七节到第十九节，你的儿女必急速归回，毁坏你，使你荒废的，都离你出去。你举目向四方观看，他们都聚集在你到你这里。耶和华说：“我指着我的永生起誓。”你必要以他们为装饰佩戴， 以他们为华带束腰，像心腹一样。至于你荒凉、荒废凄凉之处，并你被毁坏之地，现今居民居住必显为太宰，吞灭你的必离你遥远。
So Jehovah promises that Zion will be rebuilt.
耶和华在这里应许说，锡安会被重建。
Now we go on further. The children of whom you were bereaved will yet say in your ears, the place is too cramped for me. Make room for me that I may live here. Then you will say in your heart, who has begotten these for me, since I have been bereaved of my children, and am barren, an exile, and a wanderer, and who has reared these? Behold, I was left alone. From where did these children come?
进一步第20节、21节，你必听见丧子之后所生的儿女说，这地方我居住太宰，求你给我地方居住。那时你心里必说，我居丧子独居，是被掳的，漂流在外，谁给我生这些，谁将这些养大呢？撇下我一人独居的时候，这些在哪里呢？
See Zion, as the faithful remnant saw even her own children go off into captivity. But now suddenly the Lord promises they will be regathered again, and the children will be like gems and a necklace around the neck of Zion.
这里我们看到耶和华这些神的渔民，他们的儿女其实也都被掳了，但是耶和华却说他要使他这些儿女都聚集归来，然后呢，好像这些渔民要以这些儿女为装饰佩戴。
Thus says the Lord God, Behold, I will lift up my hand to the nations and set up my standard to the peoples, and they will bring your sons in their bosom.And your daughters will be carried on their shoulders. Kings will be your guardians, and their princesses your nurses. They will bow down to you with their faces to the earth and lick the dust off your feet. And you will know that I am the Lord. Those who hopefully wait for me will not be put to shame.
22节、23节，耶和华如此说。我必向列国举手，向万民竖立大旗，他们必将你的众子怀中抱来，将你的众女肩上扛来，列王必做你的养父，王后必做你的乳母，他们必将脸伏地向你下拜，并舔你脚上的尘土，你便知道我是耶和华，等候我的必不至羞愧。
So Jehovah is saying, even though your children are in the captivityI'll have the Gentile nations take care of them and bring them back like they were their foster children back to Zion.
耶和华在这里告诉他，虽然说你的儿女，你被掳，儿女都被掳了，但是我要让这些外邦人将你的儿女好像作为领养的一样，然后有一天要把他们带回来。
Now he continues to encourageZion, his remnant. Can the prey be taken from the mighty man, or the captives of a tyrant be rescued? Surely, thus says Jehovah, even the captives of the mighty man will be taken away, and the prey of the tyrant will be rescued. For I will contend with the one who contends with you, and I will save your sons.I will feed your oppressors with their own flesh, and they'll become drunk with their own blood, as with sweet wine. And all flesh will know that I, the Lord, am your Savior and your Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob.
耶和华进一步鼓励他的渔民讲到第24节和第26节勇士夺去的岂能夺回？被掳掠的岂能解救吗？但耶和华如此说，就是勇士所掳掠的也可以夺回，强暴人所抢的也可以解救，与你相争的我必与他相争，我要拯救你的儿女，并且我必使那欺压你的吃自己的肉，也要以自己的血喝醉，好像喝甜酒一样，凡有血气的必都知道我耶和华是你的救主，是你的救赎主，是雅各的大能者。
And so Jehovah finishes this chapter encouraging Zion, the faithful remnant.
所以耶和华就结束了这一章，鼓励锡安他忠心的渔民。
And Isaiah prophesies of something that will happen way down in history.
以赛亚在这里所预言的，就要在历史的长河很后面发生的事情。
He's not talking about the Babylonian captivity. He's not talking about the Roman captivity. He goes all the way back to the end of time, where that strong man, the Antichrist, will be overthrown by the Messiah, and the people will be restored to glory in Zion.
他在这里并不单单讲到说巴比伦的被掳或者是罗马的被掳，他直到讲到末世，就是当敌基督把神的渔民掳到巴别的时候，当主耶稣有一天神要救回你的儿子们。
So the Lord speaks these encouraging words about their children, the Zion, the faithful remnant.
所以神在这里对锡安他忠心的渔民们说这些鼓励的话语。
But the thought continues as God warns those who are unfaithful to him.
但是神在这里的思路进一步讲下来，讲到对那些对他不忠心的人的警告。
As you can see, we come into Isaiah chapter 50, the first three verses, but it's actually the end of the thought, and the chapter break should be after the third verse in chapter 50.
我们到这里看到五十章的前三节，这三节呢虽然是在五十章，其实它是这一段歌的最后的一段其实应该在这里来 分段。
And so here we find in Isaiah 50 verse 1, Thus says Jehovah, Where is the certificate of divorce by which I have sent your mother away? Or to whom of my creditors did I sell you? Behold, you were sold for your iniquities, and for your transgressions, your mother was sent away.
五十章第一节，耶和华如此说：我休你们的母亲休书在哪里呢？我将你们卖给我哪一个债主呢？你们被卖是因你们的罪孽，你们的母亲被休是因你们的过犯。
Now you see, some people, that is the unfaithful, don't trust Jehovah, and they feel like Jehovah has divorced himself from his people.
我们看到那些不忠心的人，他们不信靠耶和华，他们以为耶和华已经好像给他的百姓一个休书了。
And so Jehovah answers, Show me the bill of divorce. I never divorced you.
所以耶和华这样回应说，你们让我看一下休书，我从来没有休了你们。
But you were sold into Babylon because of your own iniquities.
你们被卖到了巴比伦是因为你们自己的过犯。
And because of your iniquities, I had to send your mother away.
是因着你们的罪孽，我必须把你们的母亲送走。
Now who is the mother?
谁是这位母亲呢？
Well, I've said here in these notes that it's Israel, but actually the mother is Zion.
我在这里写的是好像是以色列，其实这个母亲是锡安。
To the Jews, Jerusalem is the mother of us all, it says in Scripture.
在圣经当中，对犹太人来讲，耶路撒冷是我们的母亲。
So as Zion is destroyed, the children think,Oh, God has divorced us, but God says, I've never divorced you. You sent yourself into captivity, and Zion had to be destroyed. I had to send her away because of your unfaithfulness.
这里当锡安被毁灭的时候，毁掉的时候，神的百姓说，哦，神好像休了我们以色列，休了锡安。但神在这里却说，不，我没有休了以色列，而是因着你们的罪，使你们被掳。
And then in those final two verses, verses 2 and 3, God rebukes these unfaithful ones.
最后的两节，第二节和第三节，神斥责这些不忠心的。
Why was there no man when I came? When I called, why was there none to answer? Is my hand so short that it cannot ransom? Or have I no power to deliver? Behold, I dry up the sea with my rebuke. I make the rivers a wilderness. Their fish stink for lack of water and die of thirst. I clothe the heavens with blackness and make sackcloth their covering.
第二节第三节，我来的时候为何无人等候呢？我呼唤的时候为何无人答应呢？我的臂膀岂是缩短，不能救赎吗？我岂无拯救之力吗？看哪，我一斥责，海就干了。我使江河变为旷野，其中的鱼因无水腥臭干渴而死。我使诸天以黑暗为衣服，以麻布为遮盖。
So you see, Zion, that is the remnant, was faithful, but the people of Judah were not faithful.
我们看到锡安神的百神的渔民是忠心的，但是犹大他们却是不忠心的。
But even then.Jehovah called out to his people, but there was no one. No one when I called, no one answered.
但是就是这样的状况，耶和华仍然呼召他的百姓。然而当神呼召的时候，却没有人答应。
When the Babylonians came, I could have ransomed you, I could have delivered you, but you never called on me. And so, don't you know I have the power to turn everything into darkness, everything.Into the desert by my power. If you'd only ask.
当巴比伦来的时候，但是呢，神的百姓却不向神来呼求，却不向神来呼喊。神告诉他们说，只要你们呼求，我可以使江使海干枯，使江河变成旷野。然而神的百姓却没有向神呼求。
And so.The section ends with that beautiful servant song contrasted again by the sin and falling short of the glory of God among the children of Israel.
所以这首歌就结束在这最后的这样一个对比当中就是那神仆人他美丽的服饰和以色列百姓他们的不忠心不信之间的对比。
But when we come to the very next verse, we see a third servant song, and we see again the beauty of the servant of the Lord as he trusts in his God.
然而当我们看到第三首仆人之歌的时候，我们看到了仆人讲到这位仆人他对神的信靠的见证。
So we come to the end of another session.We realize how wonderful the servant of the Lord is, how faithful he is, how patient he is with us.
我们就来到了这一段的结尾，我们看到了神的仆人，他是多么的信实，他对我们是多么的充满了耐心等待。
And if you are faithful to the Lord, don't be discouraged. There's great promises of what God will do.In the day of his favor and restoring the children and the city of God, the church and the people of God.
如果你是服侍神的，你不要沮丧。在有一天他被高举那一日，他要恢复神所要赐给你的一切的恩典，所要给你的一切的荣耀，在他的教会当中。
So let's pray.
让我们来祷告。
Lord, we come to you, we want to serve you, but we often feel our frailty. We feel worn out sometimes and think things have been served in vain.
让我们来服侍你的时候，很多时候我们感到我们的软弱，我们好像都很失败，没有办法来服侍你。
But we look away from our feelings and our soul.And we look to the Lord and to your promises and to your rewards and to your comforts and consolation.
但是当我们不看我们自己的魂，我们来仰望我们的主的时候，我们来看你给我们的鼓励，你给我们的帮助。
Lord, even though we may be going through a difficult time right now, we know that you have future plans of grace and blessing for us.
主啊，哪怕我们现在经历一个非常艰难的时刻，但是当我们看到你将来所为我们所预备的计划，所为我们预备的祝福。
And so we put our trust in the Lord our God, even Jesus, who faithfully went through this earth so faithfully. Lord, we want to follow in your footsteps.
所以我们就信靠我们的神，就像我们的主耶稣在地上的时候是那样的忠心，他是十分的忠心，然后经历所受的一切。
Lord, we thank you for these great pictures of our Lord Jesus.
主，我们谢谢你给我们这么多关于主耶稣基督的图画。
Help us also bear the testimony of Jesus in this world.
帮助我们也在这个世界上能承受耶稣基督的见证。
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
奉靠耶稣的名祷告，阿门。